Hi guys, it is a new week and we're going to go down and look and see what the weekly string is. String 76, is that where we're at? Yep, that's where we should be. All right, string 76 is that one. That's interesting. I'm going to just draw that real quick. Looks like that. Give that a little quick. I always give myself a border just because I like one. Not everybody does. And it looks like, let me turn it this way so I'm going the same direction as, it's kind of like that. Like that, and one down there. Something kind of like that. That's the string. Now, you may notice on the website, there is something new happening here. I want to let you know about this. Become a creative pattern tangling coach. So if you are wanting to teach, but you know that you don't want to become a certified Zentangle teacher, or that that is way out of your price range, or being able to travel to do that, it's not everybody's cup of tea, but you want to teach people the joy of this art form and pattern tangling. Ina has come up with a way to do that using her website and her method of teaching, which is creative pattern tangling and not Zentangle, which is slightly different. I mean, yes, we're using the same patterns, but the methodology and the reasoning behind the way it's taught is different. So if you would like to become a creative pattern tangling coach, click on that page. There's all sorts of interesting information here about it. It, you for only $1, gives you access to the two ebooks that you need, to read about it. And she's really not asking a lot of money. She's very, very reasonable. She's just asking basically for paying for her intellectual property, the time and the talent it takes her to create the documents. And it's super reasonable price. Super reasonable. So $1 will give you the two ebooks, will give you the Coaching and Creative Pattern Tangling Volume 1 and the Creating Pattern Tangling Beginner's Guide Volume 1. You'll get both those volumes, plus the access to the Facebook group, all for only $1. And then you can read about it and see if it's something that is something that you would want to pursue going forward. And there is a test. You read the information, you gather the information, and then you have 2 weeks to take the test to get to the first stage of becoming a coach. And then after that, there are other stages, but, you know, I just wanted to let you know that it's out there, that if you are not a beginner, but you feel like you are experienced enough to teach, and you want to share this information, absolutely. This is exciting. And the minimal amount that she's charging is for her intellectual and for her knowledge and her resources. And it also is what supports this website. I mean, this website isn't free. She's paying a lot of money to have this website and have it the absolutely spectacular resource that it is. And she gives that away for basically for free. So in order to support her, even if you don't think you want to become a coach, but if you just want to learn about it, it's only cost you a dollar. I mean, you spend more than that, you know, buying a package of tissues, right? So anyway, some people equate money to cups of coffee. I don't drink coffee, so yeah, it's way cheaper than a cup of coffee. You know, for me, it's the sale price of a box of tissues. If you can spend that, a dollar is nothing. It really isn't. Okay, so we're going to go to Pattern Focus to find this week's patterns. And I don't know why I'm all congested again. It seems like I'm congested a lot. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, so here we go. We're going to go scroll down, go find today's pattern. Come on. And this one is by Trisha Long, and it's called Zebra Leaf. So, step one is going to be to make sort of a organic line and then aura that. So, come up one way and come back the other, or come up this side and go back that way. Just sort of an S snaky shape that comes to a point. Okay. See that? I'm a little far away. There we go. That's better. Step two. Oh, and it's open at this end. That's important, right? Step number two is from the point coming down almost to where that is, but not quite. Make a curve of some type. Now, this one's just a roundy curve. This one's kind of got a swoop to it. I think it just matters not what exactly the shape is. Just make a curve going this way and this way. Okay. And then you're going to put the arches in like you're going to do striping. Simple. And then color it in for striping. And then you can shade the green up. Always the wherever the green shows is pencil. So you're going to put your pencil right in here and then shade. And make sure you blend it out. And then you can fill in that middle one too. The And then of course, using colors is spectacular with this particular pattern. And look at this like cluster of these leaves. This is really cool. Okay, so it's zebra leaf. And this string, which was what, oh, I didn't write down what string number it was, 76, string 76. This string obviously goes really well with a leaf-shaped pattern, so I will go ahead and draw that. I'm going to turn on my light, get that out of the way. Close your eyes, everyone. There we go. I think I'm going to do it on a tan tile. Let me go ahead and do my border. I was watching that Jerry's Artorama videos, like I've mentioned before. And he said that he likes putting a frame on the page because it gets you in that mood that you are making a drawing. You're making a piece of art. It gives you an anchor, and I feel that way too. I feel like even if I don't end up using it, if I start out with having it on the page, there's something that just says, you know, you're now making art when I put the frame on there. I don't know why, it just does. Sorry, I got a little issue here. Ugh. Okay. Sometimes, you know, your body does things that you don't want it to do. And so you just have to take care of it. All right. So string 76 kind of comes up like this. And it has a V shape here. And a V shape there. And a V shape here. And I'm just going to give that as a general light idea of how I want to incorporate these leaf shapes. And I'm just going to start drawing. I'm going to start with the middle one, I think. And I'm going to come up here, and I'm going to come up like that, and then I'm going to come back like that. Simple. And then from here, I'm going to come up and around. And from here, that was a little, I should have come a little bit more this way, but that's okay. And come up and around like that. And then from this tip, I am going to make these little archies. Okay. And then this way, I'm going to do the same thing. Like that. And then we'll do our striping, but I think I'm going to do all the striping last because I'm going to switch over to my bigger pen. And so here I'm going to do again. I'm going to start here and I'm going to come something like that. You'll notice I'm not touching them in the middle here because I want to connect them with like some sort of stem thing coming up this way, but I haven't decided exactly how big these leaves and these ones at the bottom are going to be. So it's going to come like this, and this one's going to come like that. And we're just going to stripe those ones. That. Maybe one more. That's really cool. I like it. Okay, so here I'm going to come up like that and come like that. Like this here, and this one's going to go back behind there. Something like that. Now we can play with the scale. You can make smaller ones, you can make bigger ones. I think up here, obviously you're gonna need to make a little bit smaller, but I think I'm gonna also play with the scale of the stripes. These, all my stripes are pretty much the similarly spaced, but I think it would make it more interesting if I have something that's spaced differently. So this one's going to come up . That's my little stem part. And there's not a whole lot of leaf showing there, but that's okay. And maybe this one a little more mature of a leaf. It's about had it. It's seen its day. And it's about ready to fall off this little bush as they do. And the lines have gotten fat and farther apart. That's how I'm interpreting that. This one is going to come up. And that's a little wide. Oh well. It's going to come here like so and like so. And then these little guys, because it's sort of a newer leaf, I think I'm going to have them come really tight together. And I'm going to put one more. Like this. I'm going to do the same thing. Really close together. Okay. And now I'm going to create kind of top piece for that. Maybe some kind of a spiral coming up. Why not? And then connect this one to this one, and this one to this one, and these guys connecting, and this one connecting to here, like that, or some such thing. That's good. I'm happy with that. I do like these little spirally bits. So I think I might have some more spirally bits coming out. Randomly. Who knows? Good. I feel like it needs one here. You may hear a little bit of construction noise today, but not near as much as last week. They have not yet poured the concrete driveway, but they are working on getting the rebar in today. So concrete should be laid tomorrow. So I'm going to try to get all of my drawings done today so that I don't have to deal with the construction noise tomorrow in my videos. Because today's stuff that they're working on is relatively quiet. That's a good thing. I like that. I like that a lot. Okay. So now I'm just going to get my bigger pen. And the reason I pick a bigger nib pen is just because it's easier to fill in with the bigger pen. That's all. No particular reason other than that. When you're doing striping, if you want to make it make some sense, you want to make sure that your stripes, the sparkle part, is laying all kind of in a row. And it doesn't matter if the row is like right down the middle. Oops. You're off screen. If it's right down the middle, or if your sparkle row is like near the edge here, or if your sparkle row is near the edge out here. But as long as your sparkle follows a path, then that's good. So can you see those light pencil lines I just put in there? I'm going to say that that's where I want my sparkle. And then when I use my pen, near that pencil line is where I'm going to keep it empty or blank. Just like that. But if you have troubles making your sparkle look right, it could be because you're kind of getting zigzaggy with it. I do have a video on sparkle, and I'm thinking about maybe making an updated one. But that's the basic thing with sparkle, is you just need to pay attention to where you are leaving that blank space. just like that. And see how that looks so totally different than the one next to it? This gives it a round shape, even though this object is not round, but it gives it a round shape. So we're going to do the same thing with this one, but I chose to put it a little bit closer to the line over there, and I'm going to see what that looks like. But this is super simple. All it is just going in and coloring in. I like to leave my spot here with like a jaggedy edge. Some people like a nice smooth edge. Either one works. Been reminded again by Ina and reviewing the things that are on her test for becoming a coach, how important it is to have muscle memory and to practice drawing your shapes. If you're having difficulties with a particular shape, you need to get out a piece of paper and you need to draw that shape over and over and over. And it helps if you draw that shape. Let's say you pick circles. Draw those circles, a whole page of circles today, and then again tomorrow, and then again the next day, and do at least 5 days in a row of practicing just circles. Remember back in the day when you were learning how to make your letters, that the teacher would make you sit down and write all A's, or all B's, or all C's, a whole stinking page of them, right? You remember that? And how absolutely awful that seemed? Well, you know what? There was a reason for that. And as awful as it was at the time, because it's like, really? I know how to draw the letter A. Why are you making me draw the letter A? I know how to draw the letter A. Now see, I'm talking and not coloring well. But anyway, but what it did was it reinforced those shapes. So now when you draw the letter A, you don't think about it. You just draw an A. And most of the time, I would say that if I told you to get out a piece of paper and draw the letter A, and do it, let's say, 6 times on a piece of paper. Most of the time, most people, when they draw their letter A, they will draw their letter A the same way every time. And it will look very similar. It's the same thing with drawing patterns. It's no different than learning how to draw the alphabet. They're simple shapes. It's, you know, circles and half circles and straight lines and curvy lines. It's all it is, simple shapes. And you draw them over and over until you get a feel for them. And then once you kind of have that down, then when your brain says, oh, you need a curve here, you make a pretty darn good curve because you've practiced curves. And if your brain says, oh, you need a really shallow curve, you've practiced shallow curves. And if your brain says, oh, I would rather have a really arched and high curve here, you've practiced arched and high curves. And then you are very accomplished at it. It's all a matter of practice. And so I'm going to do this without putting the line there because that was actually distracting me. I'm going to erase those. So what I'm trying to say is you do need to practice. If you want to get better, you need to practice. The other What was I trying to say? Other types of people who teach other drawing methods, not necessarily Zentangle particular, but just in general, other drawing methods, they don't always emphasize the importance of muscle memory and practicing particular shapes. You know, like if you were taking an art class and they wanted you to draw a landscape, for example. Sometimes they focus more on the entire overall view of the landscape and don't teach you to practice a tree shape or a branch shape or a, you know, if you're going to do a cityscape, you know, they don't tell you to take out a piece of paper and practice hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times drawing box-like shapes that turn into houses. They just don't do that. But you need that muscle memory in order to draw well. So we do encourage you to get out your drawing paper and to practice your straight lines, practice your circles, practice your C shapes, your S shapes, practice your heart shapes. Heart shapes are the worst. I have a really hard time with heart shapes, getting them to look symmetrical. Sometimes it doesn't matter if your heart shape looks symmetrical, but sometimes you want a nice symmetrical heart. Well, in order to do that, you really just need to practice the shape. That's one of the ones I need to practice. Something doesn't look quite right with this. Yeah, that's where it goes, but it doesn't look right. But I was reminded of that while I was studying for my test. And yes, I am going to study for the test because some of the things that I may think about tangling and patterns may not be what Ina wants to teach us and how she wants her method of being a coach implemented. And so I am studying for the test. Don't know if I will ever teach classes in person, but I may. I like the idea of calling yourself a coach and not a teacher, because I'm really just encouraging you and coaching you through a process rather than teaching you something specific. Oh, goodness sakes, I forgot to change my battery and it's now blinking at me. I'm probably not going to be able to finish this. So if my video unexpectedly ends, it's because I've run out of battery. That was a rookie mistake, Dawn. Forgot to change batteries before I started. So this camera has been used all weekend taking pictures of the yard stuff. I should have known better. Oh well. It is what it is. You guys have the gist of this pattern, right? You got the idea. So when I abruptly end, I'm just going to keep going until I'm either finished or my battery dies, one or the other. But I just looked up and it's just blinking at me. So the possibility of it ending unexpectedly is very high. Just saying. So far so good though. Maybe I ought to show you what it looks like when you shade before it disappears altogether. Come right in here. Get that graphite right in there. Okay, and then blend with your blending stump. Just like that. Nice and soft. You don't want to mash down your paper when you're blending. Because you want to have the ability to add extra layers. Let me do this one. I'm going to do a little bit more here because this leaf is on top of that one. So I want to do this shape like that. And then this one like this. Like that. And then maybe I want some here. On my stem. Like so. And then because I'm on a toned tile, I can use my white and I can highlight right in here. What the highlighting does, it just makes it pop. I love the highlighting. Just like that. Oh, how pretty that is. I love it. Okay, I'm going to continue on filling in. Oops, bigger pen. I want you guys to be able to see the whole thing. Sad that it's probably going to stop too soon. Of course, I am taking a while to draw this one. That's okay. I'm just having fun. Enjoying my day. Having a little bit of creative play. You know, once you've learned your shapes and your patterns, then you can just start playing. And that's the most important thing is in creative pattern tangling is to play. You know, we forget to play as a species. We forget to play. I want this one here. Like that. Make my... On this one, I'm going to make it really skinny, my sparkle part. Sort of as a contrast to the big leaf part. Is a skinny sparkle. Kind of like that. Okay, and then it's over here. Like that, and pretty much that whole thing there. You won't really see it. And same thing up here. Okay. All right. Let's do some shading. Right along here, right along here. Right along here. This one. Really overlaps there. It's going to cover up a lot. Just a little bit there. Okay.